I'm telling you, I love this movie so much, and it gets very, very exciting, and that scene at the end is, like, insane. But tell everyone what it's about.
I play a prima ballerina, don't get me started. And then I have a career-ending injury, and I get kind of forced into the Russian version of the CIA, the SVR, and I go to a program that is based on reality. This book was written by a spy, where young men and women are trained in the psychological manipulation and in sex. And then I prevail by using my mind.
Yes, it's really, really clever.
And my accent.
Yeah, and you kind of, when it ends, you look back and you go, ah, and it kind of helps you follow that path of how you got there.
Yeah, that's key.
Yes, or else we'd be like, what? You're naked in this film, mm-hmm. and you've always said that you would not do that.
Yeah.
Tell everyone why you made that choice.
I finally just got hot.
You heard that Nelly song and you took off your clothes.
It was really an amazing script and story to me. I loved the character and I just didn't want to miss out on it because of like my weird insecurities. So I did it. And on the day, it was really lovely.
It was the first day, right?
It wasn't the first day of shooting.
Oh.
That would have been insane.
I thought it was.
Hello. No, I mean, most of the guys I've all known, like, from Hunger Games, which I think makes it better.
Everyone on the set, the crew.
Yeah, all of the crew. Yeah. They were all from Hunger Games. But they were really nice, and they all went in at, like, 3 a.m. to set up heaters, because it was, like, a very Hungarian winter. And I was always complaining about being cold. And so I came in and it was like so toasty and warm. And I was like, what are you doing with this heat? My nipples are gonna be huge. And everyone's like, what does she want?
We can't win with her.
Yeah, the crew was like, Jen, you can't diet anymore.
Yeah. So you did 60 Minutes and you live in my old home.
Yes.
And it was so fun to watch what you've done with my home because I like it.
You do?
I love it. Yeah, it looks great. Your friends surprised you with a self-portrait.
Yeah, my friends are total jerks. They're the worst.
Why was that so embarrassing to you?
It was humiliating. This is why it was embarrassing to me. So my mom comes over to my house. And she has this painting, and I haven't seen it yet. And she goes, I just have to tell you something about, oh my God, please. Oh my God, it's so embarrassing. My mom thought this was a masterpiece. She said it was worth easily $3 million. And my friend, Justine, the Italian one, was there for this, for my mom saying, this is an absolute masterpiece. And me being like, Mom, please just throw it in the garbage. Like, please, can we just, it's not a masterpiece.
How old were you when you painted it?
I was like, I don't know, 16. I was way too old to paint. I'm not an artist. And so my friend was there and clocked it, and I knew that was bad. So I hid it in my garage, and she found it the day that 60 Minutes was coming. And, you know, like, 60 Minutes is coming. I'm, like, so nervous. I'm like, what are you guys going to talk about? What are you going to say? And they're like, come on. And then they go and do something like that.
Well, I thought it was really good. So we have a surprise for you. So let's show everyone. Let's go outside.
No, that's not real. Thanks. That's not real, right? Is that real? I don't know. Is it magic? Oh my God! Look at the nose. Look at the lips. $3 million. That is a master. Okay, that's a masterpiece.
All right.
It's starting to feel like some sort of pawn.
Yeah. All right, you're known as one of the most relatable, candid stars in the world, and we're going to see how honest you are a little later. We're going to play Burning Questions.
Oh, boy.
Red Sparrow opens in theaters today. I recommend it highly. Go see it.